of class 6. Welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidarbhan High Secondary School. And this video is for class 6 physical science. The chapter what I will continue today is common machines, and this part is part 6. In the previous video I have discussed about the classes of the levers. Three types of the levers, right? The first class, the second class, and the third is class 3 or third class. Video, I have already discussed about the first class and the second class levers. In this video, I am going to discuss the third class lever or class 3 lever. Okay. So, in this class 3 lever, here also the fallopian is actually like the second class lever. Like the fallopian is situated in one end of this lever. But there is some differences by which the second class and third class levers are different from each other. Okay. So what is the class 3 lever? In class 3 lever, the effort or force is applied that they allow you to move a large output load with a small effort. So the load and the effort are the forces. The mechanical advantage gained with first class levers and second class levers makes it seem like that you get something or nothing, moving a large load with a smaller effort. Actually, this is the main functions of it. Like when we use small effort, but we do a large work by this small effort. The catch is that to make the effort smaller, you have to move a greater distance. For example, ample while lifting a weight with a rod or pole supported by a pivot below, the trade-off of that you need to push the lever down for that to move the load up in smaller distance. A third class lever does not have this mechanical advantage, or either the first class or the second class levers, and so examples are less common. The effort and the load are both on the same side of the fulcrum, but the effort is closer to the fulcrum than the load. So more force is put in the effort than is applied to the load. These levers are good for grabbing something small, fairly or dirty, or picking up something that could be smashed or broken if too much pressure is applied. Okay, so these are the mechanical advantage of the various types of the lever. So today in this class, the classes of lever now have been completed. Next day we will start about, giving you the idea about the inclined plane. Okay, in this class I will discuss mainly the class 3 levers. The first class lever is something where the fulcrum is in the middle. Okay, but in the second and the third class, in both way the fulcrum is on the one side. But what are the difference between the second class and third class lever? In the second class, the weight was in the middle and the force was inside. And in the third class, this is the third class lever, where the fulcrum is in one side and the load in the other side, but the effort is in the middle. Okay, so by this, I am completing this classes of the lever. In the next class, I will start the inclined plane. Till then, thank you.